This is an audio essay meant to be consumed as a podcast. If you want to watch highly produced video essays, just go to my main channel, IDB. Thanks. Okay, in this audio essay, I want to talk about Sneeko because I can't stop thinking about what he is doing and I've been watching his content on his second channel, Sneeko, recently. Okay, so I will divide this audio essay into three parts. First part would be YouTube's golden boy. Here I will talk about my initial take on Sneeko and when he started all these live streaming shenanigans this summer. Second part would be wasted potential. Here I would be talking about why I started disliking him after watching more and more of his streams and his hot takes on women and other stuff. Third part would be my conspiracy. Here I would be disclosing you why he is doing what he is doing. If you really think the essay is too long for you or maybe gets boring in between, then please just skip to the part 3 straight away. Because I really want you guys to listen to what I have to say about this Sneeko and why he is a genius in disguise. Well, maybe. Okay, so let's begin with the first part, YouTube's golden boy. I've been following Sneeko since 2019 and I've really looked up to him as a creator and I've always thought of him as a YouTube's golden boy. He was probably the only YouTuber I thought was authentic and wasn't scared to speak the truth even if it comes at the cost of the backlash. He has always been transparent with his viewers about his life and his flaws. That's what made him so admirable among his subscribers. We never really saw Sneeko as an influencer but as a person just like us. To the extent, at least me, I saw somewhat myself in Sneeko. And I'm not even gonna fucking lie. Call me a dick rider all you want, I don't care. Okay, so when Sneeko started all these livestream shenanigans this summer, the first thing he did was calling out another YouTuber, Hamza, for being a cult leader because people kept spamming his streams to react to Hamza. He never bought into the idea of cults, which I totally agree with. Even I made a really good fucking video essay on Hamza's cult. You should watch that on my main channel only if you enjoyed the audio essay here. I'm not forcing you to anything, okay? And when Hamza made a reply video titled "Don't End Up Like Sneeko," Hamza got really fucking personal to him by comparing Sneeko to his younger brother and saying Sneeko fell off because his views started to go down. I was really fucking pissed at Hamza at that time, to be honest, because Sneeko called out his cult bullshit and Hamza replied making personal comments saying he fell off because his main channel doesn't get views. I knew Sneeko never chased the concept of views because he has always cared about quality over quantity. That made me support Sneeko even more and I kept watching his Europe vlogs and then his streams. Later he started to react to Andrew Tate. Andrew Tate, if you don't know who he is as a Sneeko viewer, you better click off this essay right now because you wouldn't even understand the rest of the shit I'm about to speak up. Trust me. Andrew spoke about how men are becoming weaker, which has very much truth to it, which makes people watch Tate more. Because when you discover all this he is saying, you think he is speaking the harsh truth that nobody wants to hear. Initially, even I agreed to Tate about being weak and not being able to fight and shit. Sneeko agreed to it too, and I was like, okay, cool. Since Sneeko agreed as well, which means I'm right for listening to Tate and his advice, since I mostly agree with Sneeko as well. Then Tate's video started to pop up all over my socials. And surprisingly, they weren't even Tate's accounts. They were made by his followers to spread his message. I don't know why. But then later I discovered that they were to promote his course, Hustlers University, and those people were also making money off it by having an affiliated link in their bio. I was like, okay, I guess if you are making money off it and also spreading his message on masculinity, then who am I to blame? Then something started to shift. As Sneeko started to stream more regularly, I started to notice how he became more and more manic. I mean, it was entertaining to watch and he even explained that he is doing it on purpose so people with low attention span stay entertained and don't click off. I agreed to him because he did have a point. But then more shit started to go down. Now this brings me to the part 2. Wasted talent. As I saw Sneeko's stream progress with days, he started to react to Tate more and started agreeing on his takes about women. How Tate says women ain't shit and only should be around you so you can fuck them and shit, and how they only belong in the kitchen and yada yada. And to my surprise, Sneeko was agreeing to all that shit, as if he is slowly becoming brainwashed by Tate and becoming a verbally outspoken misogynist. He openly started to shit talk about women, calling them the weaker sex and whatnot, and then got too deep into this Matrix shit and calling other people bots. He then started asking people to share clips from his live streams to post all over TikTok to spread his message. The only things I agreed about his take was how most people aren't even depressed and how TikTok is a cruel Chinese app, and which I totally agree. I mean, TikTok has been banned in my country since 2020. But then later he introduced the concept of this creator kit where he would teach people how to be an independent creator and ask people to put an affiliated link in their bio so they can earn half of the money when people sign through it. But he always had his Patreon, so why this course? This was probably my last pro, I guess, because this is clearly a pyramid scheme like Tate is running. I've been following Sneeko for years and to be really fucking honest, I would expect him to be the last person to fall for this bullshit. A person who has always been so against the mob mentality and prioritizing quality over quantity, I did not expect this from him. A person who loves to be around people, talking to them to get their perspective on certain topics and issues, was out here hating on people and calling them bots. I genuinely thought this motherfucker is really fucking brainwashed at this point. A person who made video essays on the meaning of life, sleepwalking through New York and stuff, isn't just summarizing life by getting money, fuck bitches on an island. He was making fun of Twitch streamers for making money by playing games, but was asking his viewers to make money by sharing his affiliated link of his course to make money and escape the Matrix. Something wasn't adding up. I really wanted to make this audio essay initially to thrash on Sneeko about how he has lost all his 9 years of credibility as a creator with these streams he has been doing. I was thinking, maybe, just maybe, Hamza was right. We shouldn't end up like Sneeko. I was really laying in my bed at 2 a.m. thinking how I should structure this essay to show how Sneeko has downgraded. I was literally staring at my ceiling, not distracted with any sort of social media because I deleted off my phone so I can think. It was the only time I was surrounded by my own thoughts that are not being influenced by anyone over the internet. Just me and my fucking thoughts. And then it hit me. Part 3, my conspiracy about this whole Sneeko outburst. And then it fucking hit me. Maybe, just fucking maybe, this motherfucker is throwing an act of being like the way he is acting right now. In short, Andrew Tate Dick Rider. To me, it felt like I opened my fucking third eye when I realized that Sneeko is probably faking it all. Because he might just be about to expose Tate and his bullshit and actually save the internet for good. I know I might sound crazy and a fucking Sneeko Dick Rider right now, but guys, you need to fucking hear me out. Okay, so it all started with Sneeko calling out Hamza for this cult bullshit, alright? How he did not buy the idea of cults. Go check his video essay titled Authenticity on his main channel. Like, check that after listening to this. Don't fucking quit this video if you have reached this far. Trust me, I'm about to spill some more on how I can be right about all this shit. And remember how Hamza said that Sneeko fell off because his views have started to go down? Well, Sneeko never changed the concept of views to begin with. He has said it in multiple videos earlier that MrBeast has given him the blueprint already to make it big on YouTube, but that's not what he wanted to do. He always knew how to get attention and get views, but always changed the concept of authenticity and quality instead. But Hamza hit a nerve, I guess. Because if a guy who just got relevant last year tells you that you fell off and starts to compare you with your younger brother... that shit is fucking annoying. And if you know Sneeko, that guy is egotistical as fuck. You might have even noticed how Sneeko keeps making fun of Hamza in each stream and tweet whenever he talks about his views and engagement now. He wants to take a piss at Hamza at how easy it is to get views and brainwash people. Which brings me to the concept of cult. Even though Hamza says he is running a cult, the real cult on the internet is being ran by Andrew Tate. So maybe by copying the strategy of Andrew Tate, he is brainwashing other people from TikTok and making them come over to his streaming channel. And later he might just expose how easy it is to brainwash people and make a cult out of it to run a pyramid scheme. Because hear me out, Sneeko posted a video on Twitter with people covering their whole face with masks that tagged Sneeko in this photo. And guess what? Sneeko posted that video with a single eye emoji. What else has a single eye? Mike Wazowski? Nah, bitch, Illuminati. And that is a cult. Sneeko clearly knows what he is doing. He is making a cult out of this bullshit. Something he was so against about and even made a video essay about it. To add more to it, he posted that video on Twitter and Instagram with the same audio he used in this video essay Authenticity while he talks about cult. Here's the visuals.
That 900, there must have been at least 250 thinking, maybe this Kool-Aid cult juice is a bad idea. But when they saw the other 650 sipping, their lives were lost to peer pressure. I always found it stupid how people are so patronizing to cults.
You see? You see it now? Wait, I got more. Sneeko has already said it in his multiple streams that don't fucking idolize him. Just come and watch streams to get entertained and get lost. But guess what people have started to do? Idolize him. If he really wanted to make more money, he would have not been constantly denying people on his streams for donating him money, rather join his Patreon so that they can get some value for their money. Look at the last design he dropped in his clothing line, Quality Clothing. Thank you for your money. I think he is genuinely taking a piss at you all, not gonna lie. But you guys must be wondering about his views on women are toxic. Wait, let me show you a clip from his video, How to View Women.
Instead of approaching women as a projection of your desires, it's better to see them as just other people. Usually people are more interesting than they seem.
Now you need to fucking believe me, man. This guy is fucking trolling and already about to fucking expose this cult bullshit that Andrew Tate is running. This motherfucker is so good at doing people's impression. You think this goofy ass motherfucker can't fake being a Tate Dick Rider? Guys, this dude is a fucking comic. I mean, when he was reacting to the video about him titled Sneeko the Kanye of YouTube, he said one thing that stuck with me. You people will always come back no matter what. I mean, Kanye is also famous for creating controversy in order to promote his new album. I really don't fucking know, man. Either Sneeko will save the internet by exposing Tate and his cult bullshit, then you better call him the golden boy of YouTube, or maybe he is just really fucking brainwashed, which I really don't fucking believe, to be honest. But if he is, then he is just a wasted talent. I don't know, guys. Maybe I'm just giving him too much credit, or maybe I'm the one who's going insane. Should I post this? I think losers are gonna call me a bot or a dick rider.
I don't even know what that means.
No one knows what it means, but it's provocative.
No, it's not. It
gets the people going.